بسم الله.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد الأمين نبي الأنبياء وخاتم المرسلين، وعلى آله وصحابته والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. هذه رايحة جاية. سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا. قال النووي رحمه الله تعالى ونفعنا به: بيان هجرة النبي المختار والغزو والحد والاعتمار. وهاجر المختار لما وصل 50 مع 30 حتى نزل بطيبة الغراء حيث أمرا، ثم بها قام حتى احتضرا فيها، فكانت أشرف البقاع، أما ضريحه فبالإجماع. أما ضريحه فبالإجماع. نعم. بيان هجرة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
أحد منهم يكون أحد منهم.
بيان هجرة النبي المختار. هذا الباب أقدم الناظم لبيان هجرة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. والهجرة هي الانتقال من مكان إلى مكان، من انتقال الإنسان من وطنه على العادة إلى مكان آخر جديد. وسبب هجرة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم سنبينه واضحا وسنوضحه، وقد وضحت أخطاء المتكلمين عن الهجرة وانتقاصهم لرسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم.
بسم الله، الحمد لله، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. This is a discussion of the hijra or migration, meaning the migration meaning and hijra the same thing, leaving one's homeland or leaving one's place of residence and traveling to somewhere far away and going and moving to a different homeland.
وسبب هجرة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وحي من الله سبحانه وتعالى.
What was the reason for the migration?
Number
one, the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
ولذلك ورد في الحديث الصحيح إن الله أذن لي. أذن هنا ليس بمعنى information. أذن أعلمني بالذهاب إلى الهجرة، لأن الله تعالى يقول: وأذن في الناس بالحج يأتوك رجال، أعلم إعلاما ليأتوك. ففي الحديث الصحيح أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال لأبي بكر وجاءه غورا: يا أبا بكر إن الله أذن لي، معناها أعلمني بوقت الهجرة، قال لي: اذهب إلى المدينة.
It's important to understand that the hijra was because of the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. People say the different reasons and so on. Really, this is the plan Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had for the believers, and the time had come for them to go, and Allah commanded them to go. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam even said this when Abu Bakr came to him one day, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told him that now Allah has adhina li. People can read that and say has given permission to me, but this is like related to adhan, that wa adhan fi nasi bil hajj. So and announce to the people that to do Hajj. So this is that.
هذا هو إذن. إذن طبعا إذن، ولكن إذن بأمر. إذن بأمر طبعا.
Is it permission? Of course, it's permission only with the permission of Allah subhanahu wa taala. But is it permission with a command? That now Allah subhanahu wa taala has commanded me. Now is the time. In other words, for Allah is telling me that now is the time for Hajj. For migration.
فهمتم أن الإذن هنا ليس كما تفهمون فقط إذن، وأن الشخص مضايق هذا ليس هو الصحيح.
So you do not take from that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was just
مضايق وكان ينتظر الهجرة من ألف سنة.
We're just waiting for the hijrah for like years, and now he's in such a bad state and so on. And because
هذا هو اللي تفهمونه. هذا هو اللي تفهمونه.
But now Allah is telling him, and now finally he's just only staying because Allah didn't tell him to leave yet. And command and give him permission to leave. No, that because that is what you understand.
هذا غير صحيح، لأن الصحابة كانوا يشتاقون إلى الرجوع إلى المدينة، لكن ما عندهم الإذن في الرجوع إليها. ففي الحديث الصحيح أن الصحابة كانوا يشتاقون إلى مكة. لحديث كثيرة في هذا. وأصابهم المرض في المدينة.
For example, that many companions they were eager to return to Medina return to Mecca.
وأصابتهم الأمراض من وباء المدينة.
And they became sick in Medina.
والله تعالى ماذا يقول عنه؟ الذين للفقراء المهاجرين الذين أخرجوا من ديارهم وأموالهم إيش؟ اسمعوا القرآن. ما هو الخروج؟ لماذا؟ يبتغون فضلا من الله ورضوانه، يطلبون فضلا من الله ورضوانه.
So the companions
اسمعوا القرآن العظيم.
Who had went ahead to Medina. It said fleeing persecution, but what? They wished they could return to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, but they were commanded to leave. It's not that they're like, oh, okay, well, finally a relief, we get to leave the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and go. They wished they could return to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They were commanded to leave. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala even says in the Quran,
يبتغون يطلبون فضلا من الله ويطلبون رضوان الله.
Who are removed from their wealth and their homes, for what reason? Seeking Allah's bounty and His pleasure. That's the reason for their migration. They were seeking Allah's pleasure. They were.
تركوا بيوتهم وأموالهم وأوطانهم يبتغون فضلا من الله
ورضوانه.
تركوا.
They left their lands. They left their home. They left their wealth, seeking Allah's pleasure.
مع حبهم لها الشديد.
Despite their love for it, but they left it seeking the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
أنا سمعت واحد سوري يتكلم باللغة العربية يقول خروج النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كخروج العراقيين من العراق.
So again, the Syrian man who's saying that.
واحد محاضر رأس المقطع إلى جميع العالم وصلني هنا في أمريكا.
Sending this a clip all over the world. That the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam's migration, the migration of the companions, is the same as the refugees crisis that's going on in the Middle East.
وقال مهجر لا مهاجر بهذا اللفظ معناها محمول هذا فقط قال مهجر.
He used the term indicating being forced to migrate, being made to leave. As opposed to a person who was willingly migrating, obeying the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Only
when the command came.
As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as was mentioned, that the angel of the mountain came to him and said that if you want, then I can crush them between the two mountains.
وكان قادرا على التدمير لو شاء لكن شاد
بالتخفيف. من أول الأمر. So just shift your perspective of the seerah to who is the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and what was he capable of, then why is he in this situation? Then understand things in context of who he is. That without that you have no seerah.
ولذلك أنتم جميعا صدقتموني. ماذا سمعت من السيرة؟ هل سمعت من السيرة شيئا يعارض هذا أو كل ما أقوله معارض لما سمعت؟
So now أنت أولهم.
أنت أولهم.
Tell me and you are.
إن كنتم صادقين.
If you are being truthful, if what you've heard of before of the seerah, is it going along with what I'm saying, or is everything I'm saying going against what you've heard in the way that you've heard the seerah taught in the past?
It's going against.
أجيب الأنسة. أنت أولهم. وأنت وأنت.
أنا كان أكبر فائدة الحمد لله السيرة.
لا أتكلم نحن لا نريد أن نكون فتحات ولكن.
So I'll say to be honest, this brother right here is sitting over here. I told him when he was listening to Sira, I said which YouTube videos should I listen to? I told him don't listen to this guy, don't listen to this guy. I said what should I listen to? I said you want to hear the Sira? Listen to Qurat al-Absar. We did a recording of it. And then afterwards, I asked him the perspective of it, of your perspective of seerah. A lot of people teach it the wrong way. The biggest benefit that I gained by the class that I translated of Qurat al-Absar was that it entirely shifted my perspective of how to view the stories about the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam entirely. I told him that. And he listened, mashallah, from the beginning and he was listening to the end.
أنا أرى seerah سلبيات. هي سلبيات على المسلمين.
So in fact, the way that seerah is taught, then it opposes the purpose of the life of the Prophet
ﷺ. Yes, سلبيات على المسلم.
It hurts the Muslims, unfortunately.
سلبيات, سلبيات. Negative. يعني سلبيات على عكسيات.
No, it opposes the.
سلبيات ليست بمعنى ما قام النبي ولا بطريقه ولا ليست سيرة النبي.
Instead of adding to them more about the Prophet ﷺ and bring them closer to the way of the Prophet ﷺ.
والله هؤلاء الناس الذين أخبروني أنهم سمعوا السيرة هنا في أمريكا ما سمعت واحدا منهم عنده تقدير لرسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم.
People justify the opposite in fact.
من أولهم إلى آخره.
People justify living a life contrary to the Prophet ﷺ and norms contrary to the Prophet ﷺ.
ما سمعت منهم شيئا يدل على تعظيم رسول الله.
Picking and choosing, cherry picking things to justify, you know, a Western American Muslim right lifestyle. So, subhanAllah, the people that have heard the seerah and learned the seerah here,
وما سمعوها,
I swear by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala,
everyone
who told me that they learned the seerah here, I do not see in them the proper respect and admiration of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
وكيف تتبعوا من لا تحترم؟
صحيح.
احترام وأصل الاتباع.
How can you follow the one that you do not respect?
ولذلك تجد واحد منهم يقول لك كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في خدمة أهلي أخرج هجر ضغط عليه كفار قريش وأخرج إلى المدينة واستقبله الأنصار وكان في ضيق وصرف وكانوا فقط خلاص يعني حصارات العراق والباكستان والأفغان وأشياء هكذا ينظرها هذه النظرة.
That is why when you ask people about the seerah they hear, they say, oh yeah, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was kicked out. He was under pressure. He was being boycotted and he was kicked out and he was this and that. He was always in the service of his family. SubhanAllah, شيء ثاني مع هذا الشخص. على الطريق إلى هنا يقول لي على السيرة الذي سمعناها. Sorry again. ونحن قال أنا أول ما سمعت في مسجد برنتوود. قال لي شخص. What did the first thing you heard about the seerah when you came to Brentwood? That somebody told you, don't say who? He told you about the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is what?
Dead.
Dead.
Yes.
What did he tell you? What proof did he provide?
The Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is
dead. Who wants to start you with the humility of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam? How do you say who is
dead? No. I said... What was the first thing that you were said? You said what story that he mentioned about the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam? Oh, about Abu Bakr Siddiq's thing.
Yeah.
Umar رضي الله عنه
was. الحديث البخاري.
Umar رضي الله عنه was.
ولكن ماذا قال أبو بكر بعد ذلك؟
فالفائدة من السيرة كانت ماذا؟ And then the Messenger.
أنت تعتقد النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم؟
That's it. Literally on the way here, discussing the first thing in my masjid that this brother learned, and I said, Alhamdulillah, he didn't learn it from me.
Yeah. I was just randomly told by somebody.
Was somebody told?
أول استقبال المسجد أخبره قالوا اعتقد النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم انقطع.
And then when you discussed with me about a group of people that were talking about the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم being alive, we both thought that these people have something wrong with them.
Yes, unfortunately.
That's my fault.
That's fine, it's growing.
Later on, I called you and said, you know, by the way, I had to, you know, take back and swallow my words and throw them in the garbage.
I guess it's probably the only thing that he swallowed.
حي ويتصرف هذه الأمور عن هؤلاء اللي يلبسون هذه العمائم الخضراء فأنكرنا ذلك عليهم سبحان الله. هو سألني عليهم فقلنا سبحان الله ما عجيب هؤلاء الذين يفعلونه ويا
قال الله من حي.
نعم
قال الله رب العزة حي وقال هو صلى الله عليه حي. تعالدون الله.
Opposing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the statements of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa
sallam.
Astaghfirullah, sorry. I learned now, alhamdulillah. Slowly learning.
Tell them what you have.
No.
Ma'ya hadith. أول مرة تستفيد من المسجد البرنوود أنك تعتقد النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قطع. هذه أول فائدة.
Right. The first thing, mashallah, that you learned coming in Brentwood Masjid, not from me, but that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is dead.
هذه أول فائدة استفادها. اعتقد أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم الآن خلاص انتهى. لا تفرق بينه وبين موت أبي جهل وأبي لهب.
Do not differentiate between the death of Abu Jahl and Abu Lahab and the death of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
هذا صحيح أم لا؟ Is right or not? Right?
Yes.
Yes. Thank you for the brand word message. Thank you for Muslims.
Well, I could say the brother that said the same thing has changed his mindset as well. So I remember afterwards things were clarified. Alhamdulillah.
He had to change. He's stupid. He had to change. He's stupid. He had to be smart. He had to leave his maqam. His maqam al hamid.
Yes, inshallah.
He's stupid, man.
Yes, inshallah. Yes.
If my sheikh said that, I will tell him, you stupid. Go outside.
Nice, sheikh.
My sheikh, I said, if this my sheikh said that, I will tell him, go outside. Not Marabah. Go. Stupid, man. I will tell him, go, get up.
Alhamdulillah, we correct.
I never give you my hand. How can kiss you? It's a different story. I never give you my hand. Go, get up.
Alhamdulillah, it's
a shaytan.
All the explanations of Abu Bakr is given in all the classes that
يدون اسمه إذا كانوا العرب يتكلموا يقولوا النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم هجة بهذا اللفظ مكرها.
If the Arabs who studied for years and years saying the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was forcefully ejected and made to migrate.
يقولوا كإخواننا العراقيين واليمنيين بهذا اللفظ.
Like our Iraqi.
قال كإخواننا الذين أخرجوا من العراق واليمن.
Like our refugee brothers from Yemen and Iraq.
كمساكين الأفغان والباكستان والعراق الذين جاءوا هنا إلى أمريكا.
Overwhelmed, no power, forced to migrate. No.
زادي كيف كان إن العراق كنت أمريكا.
That's the analogy of the process. That's the thought of the process.
ليش اسم ساكن كم هي؟ زادي ونكيف جمدين. Exactly. صار فرصة. وبعهم نعم وهاجر المختار النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وحي إليه بالهجرة وهاجر أصحابه أكثرهم أو كثير منهم قبله صلى الله عليه وسلم كثير من الصحابة هاجروا بأمر من النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم إلى بلاد المدينة لينشروا الإسلام هناك وطبعا كان مقصدهم الأول نشر الإسلام ولذلك ما بقي بيت من المدينة إلا ودخله الإسلام قبل دخول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم المدينة
So then you have the companions beginning the migration and many of them and perhaps most of them who had migrated they migrated before the Prophet sallallahu
alaihi wasallam.
And to the point that when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had come and was welcomed in the manner that he was welcomed joyfully that there was no house in Medina except Islam had already entered into.
وكانوا يخرجون في قرية
حتى من اليهود من
الأنصار
from the Ansar from the
يهود قليل
but the Jews unfortunately the vast majority of them were
أخرجوا بعد ذلك نبأهم عمر بعد ذلك
عمر رضي الله عنه
أخرجهم من جزيرة العرب
kicked them out of the Arabian Peninsula
أخرجهم عمر مباشرة قالوا من يهود ما عندكم مكان هنا أصلا
that's it That's it, their time over there was done. But when we say the Ansar then, they are, unfortunately, the vast majority of the Jews then we are, they're excluded and exempted from that statement, of that honor, by being the ones who were rejected the Messenger of the Prophet ﷺ. But the Islam had entered the house of the Ansar, meaning of the Aus and the Khazraj, the Arab tribes.
المهم وكان من آخرهم خروج عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله تعالى.
So even when the statement Medina, every house in Medina, the houses of the Jews were not even honored to be included in that statement.
وخرجوا.
And they were removed by the time of عمر رضي الله عنه.
وكان من آخر المهاجرين قبل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم عمر بن الخطاب.
Who عمر رضي الله عنه himself, he is one of the last of those who migrated.
ولما خرج ذهب أراد الخروج تقلد السيف هو ذهب إلى أكابر قريش أبي جهل وأبي لهب والوليد بن المغارة ودق أبوابهم واحدا واحدا.
But instead of leaving secretly like everybody else, that was not for عمر رضي الله عنه. He took his sword, hung
تقلد سيفه بنفسه ما معه أي شخص.
Went by himself to the doors
ومر على رؤساء قريش واحدة أبي جهل.
One by one.
هل فلان هنا؟
Is Abu Lahab home?
نعم. قل له يخرج هنا عمر
يتولى. Tell him Umar is waiting for him.
إن أردت أن تفقدك زوجتك ويتم أولادك فالحقني بهذا الوقت.
If you want
واحدا واحدا.
Your wife to be widowed. If you want your children to be orphaned, then
عليك أن تقابلني في هذا الوقت قبل أن أخرج من مكة في هذا الوقت.
I'm leaving Mecca. You want to
لكن قبل أن أخرج من حدود مكة ميعاد هنا.
So there's no nobody gets twisted that Umar left because he was forced out or kicked out. He said if you wanna, he couldn't move mountains, but at least he could knock on their doors and tell them you want your wife to be widowed and your children to be orphaned. Meet me in.
الحقني بهذا الوقت فقط هذا الوقت. نازل في مكة هنا.
Meet me in the valley here in Mecca.
أما من أحد منهم أخرج رأسه.
None of them dared. Oh, sorry.
هذا الأمر خطير. هذا نحن نعرف أن الأمر سيقع لا نهاية. نحن نعرف أن الأمر سيتحقق.
Please leave a message for.
ما منهم أحد قبل الدعوة. ما في واحد قبل.
None of them accepted his generous invitation.
فخرج عمر بنفسه ما شاء الله الأمر عادي. سيفه لم يعمل شيئا. بقي في قلادته حتى ما أخرجه من غمده.
He left like he was going to the grocery store. You know, he his sword stayed.
ما أخرجه من غمده. بقي في غمده حتى وصل.
He removed his sword from its place. That's it. Walking.
حتى وصل إلى المدينة.
Until he got to Medina.
حتى أبو جهل ما حلم في النوم أن يخرج من بيته يا عمر.
أبو جهل and أبو لهب couldn't even dream in their.
هذا يعرفون الخطورة. هذا مقام الخطورة.
That they would go after him.
اسمعوا الحقيقة. اسمعوا حقيقة الهجرة.
So listen to the reality of the hijra.
هذا عمر هذا ليس رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم.
This is Umar رضي الله عنه, not the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
هذا حال رجل مقهور.
This is the state of an individual who has just had it up to here with these people.
هذا مقهور هذا رجل مقهور مجبور.
This is somebody who is being forced and kicked out.
يدور على أبواب رؤساء قريش واحدا واحدا من أراد أن تفقده زوجته. أو يتم أولاده فلين حقنهم
قال going door to door and making this announcement to find them clearly.
هل رأيت مقهورا يطوف بالأبواب؟
Do you see somebody who is being kicked out and exiled and made a refugee doing this?
هذه معروفة لا تفتح كتابا من السيرة إلا وموجودة.
So this is known in every book of Sira that's there. How do you miss
لماذا لا تقصون على الناس هذا؟
Why didn't you tell يقصون ولكن لا يدرون ما هو يعني المعنى.
ما المعنى ما في ذلك؟
نعم طبعا جدا.
من يقص؟
وحتى أنا سمعت قصة يعني هذا طائف ولكن مر علينا هذه القصة وملك الجبال مع ملك الجبال ولكن لا ندري ما هو المقصود المعنى. Many times many of the things. That Sheikh Sadiq is saying that but they don't say this part. I've heard that part a million times. It wasn't driven home. What is the point of that part? Then that's even worse. You heard that you didn't get the point. The person who is sharing it with you doesn't understand the point. He didn't. Everything else he said has defied that point. That's why the point was impossible to see.
معناها السمع الطالب والمطلوب السامع والمستمع المسمع والمستمع ما في واحد يفهم.
That means the person who is teaching the lesson, the person who is hearing the lesson, there's no.
والنتيجة من المعلم أن يضع الأصول على النقط على معانيها.
Because what is the point of the teacher is to put everything in its place to deliver to you the lessons.
هذا معنى التعليم. لا يقال له الرواية. لا يقال له الرواية.
Anybody can just read a book to you.
هذا يقال له الرواية. هذه الرواية.
That's just reading and narrating.
أنا سمعت من فلان ولكن لم يفهم. هذا يقول.
I've heard from such and such individual who didn't.
هذا هو تعلم فلان. أقول هذا سمعت والسامع والمسمع ما فهمه. نكون صادقين.
So if somebody is narrating, they're narrating. They're saying something. I heard these words come out of this person's mouth. And that's as far as it goes. I heard the seerah mentioned. I didn't memorize it. I didn't remember it. I didn't understand the point of it. What I was hearing.
حتى ولا المعلم ما يفهم هذا. المعلم لا يفهم.
وهذا لا بأس ولكن إن دققوا معاني
ويعني
بعكس المعنى فالذي يسمع يعني طبعا الذي يسمع سيرة ولا يفهم منها شيء هذا يأخذ البركة على قلب
لكن هو لا يفهم هو يأخذ بالسلبيات
نعم هذا
يأخذ بالسلبيات أنا كما قلت لك هي مصيبة
It's a huge. It's so then the point is, this is the point of what's meaning that a negative understanding, that or opposite understanding. A person literally began and read the book of the Sirah from beginning to end without explaining any point. Simply it coming in one ear and going out the other. At least, mashallah, it's cleaning your insides as it's passing through your ears. But if a person is emphasizing points, and look at how Khadija radhiyallahu anha is a businesswoman, and look at how, mashallah, this and that, and look at how every point that's being mentioned that's actually being focused in on... with the whole opposite understanding of
the
and mashallah, every feminist leaves the gathering thinking that, mashallah, look, I'm being... and if it wasn't for Khadija, then the Prophet
would...
as if the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم was Khadija.
تخرجون من المجلس بأن خديجة هي التي رفعت راية الإسلام.
That she, that Khadija was the one, you know, Islam is because of her, and that's it. Despite her great contributions, but who was she and what was her modesty and status as the wife?
ولكن هي دعما هي حتى يعني ما أخذت مقاما إلا من رسول الله. من هي ومن
هو؟ Where is her status?
من هؤلاء الناس؟
Because of her affiliation with the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. What wealth benefited to her? That she let the Prophet ﷺ use it for that which
was different.
She was dreaming day and night of
this
whole plot to have the Prophet ﷺ, you know, to consider her. For years and years, you know,
thinking,
how can I, you know, figure this out?
نعم. فلما وصل الأمر إلى هجرة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم، هجر الصحابة، لأن ما نريد أن نطيل بالأمر، نريد أن ندقق معاني مهمة جدا، لأن الوقت يضيق عن ذلك. خرج النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم، أذن الله تعالى له في الهجرة، وقص الله تعالى قضية الهجرة. قال تعالى سبحانه لما أعلمه بالهجرة قال إن قريش خططوا خطة واضحة وإذ يمكر بك الذين كفروا لما علمونه سيهاجر لأنهم عرفوا ما يتابعونه يوما هم يحسون أن الهجرة حان وقتها لأنهم رأوا الصحابة ذهبوا وعرفوا أن الأمر يعني صار سيأتي من النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم بقبائل شتى وجيوش معلوم عرفوا هذا فصاروا يلتمسون وقت الهجرة.
So then the disbelievers as the hijrah was coming closer, they were fearful of the
hijrah.
They see that the signs are happening, the people are leaving, they're fearful of what's going to happen if the Muslims go. They're going to gather, they said the Arabs are going to gather and they're going to come and
destroy.
That's it, we're finished. We have to deal with the situation. That means the hijrah is not them being kicked. It's we have a limited time where we think we even, where we can still even dream of having the possibility of dealing with the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
نحن نعرف أنه سينتصر علينا قريبا.
We know that his victory is inevitable.
حان الوقت، العلامات دخلت.
That the time is coming closer.
فعلموا أن صاروا يتجسسون لهجرته يعرفون.
So they started spying on when is the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم going to migrate.
فرأوا النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ذاهبا إلى أبي بكر. تابعوا الأمر، عرفوا الأمر.
So of course there's many details, but of course we have to skim over a lot of things because of time. So just focusing on the main points, once they knew
that the Prophet was certain,
they gathered a group of people.
كما قال تعالى وإذ يمكر بك الذين كفروا ليثبتوك أو يقتلوك أو يخرجوك ويمكرون
And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions this, that if once the disbelievers, they were plotting to either kill you or kick you out or arrest you, imprison you. And they were plotting, but Allah's plot is supreme. That and amongst them in that gathering, now everybody's giving their opinions and, you know, arrest him, no. To kick him out, well, they're going to just come and back and destroy us. Right, put him into prison, he's got everybody's going to... anybody you put to guard him, he's going to become a believer, and there he goes, right? kick him out, he's gonna come back as.
وحضرهم الشيطان سبحان الله.
They kill him. His people are gonna destroy us and so on. What are we gonna do?
حضرهم الشيطان.
The shaytan, mashallah, thinking his expert opinion once more. سبحان الله رأيه كان في إبراهيم عليه السلام. الشيطان كان رأيه في إبراهيم عليه السلام أفسد عليهم الأمر وجعل.
والشيطان ما كان رأيه ورأي جهل. هما تخالفوا بعضهم قال نخرجوه بعضهم نسجنوه فقال أبو جهل لا بل نجمع له شبة من قريش ويضربونه ضربة رجل واحد حتى يتبرق دمه في القبائل والشيطان جالس يستمع.
Now ما شاء الله the shaitan is listening.
وهو في صورة شيخ النجدي صورة كرجل من النجد.
He's in the shape of a old Najdi
man من رياض نجد.
A man for example, a city
عاصمة السعودية. كابيتال السعودية. نعم صورة الشيخ النجدية. وجالس والشيطان ولكن يعتقد أنه رجل النجد.
So the shaitan is sitting there, but they think that he's an old man who came from.
ويجلس فقط يستمع فقط كراجل حاضر فقط. فقال جماعة قال بعضهم نحن نخرجه بعضهم نسجنه قال هاي ليست فكرة خلوا دعوكم هذا. فلما وصلت خطة أبي جهل قال نجمع شبة من قريش شباب من قريش مختلفين القبائل ويضربونه عندما يخرج يضربونه ضربة رجل واحد فيتفرغ دمه في القبائل فسيرضى بنو هاشم بما يريدون من المال ولا قدرة لهم على معاداتنا أبو جهل.
So Abu Jahl gave his expert opinion. He said, look, none of these things will work. The only solution is to kill him, and the only way we can kill him is by without getting the blood feud amongst us.
جميع من قبائل قريش.
Is to make a representative from each one of the tribes of Quraysh, and then they all
يضربون ضربة رجل.
With the same strike, and then the blood
حتى لا يعلم من قتل.
Amongst them, so that no one knows, and then the Bani Hashim will have no choice but to accept blood money.
لا قدرة لهم على معادة العدو.
They cannot fight everybody. And then
فسيرضون بالمال وسنعطيهم منه ما يريدون خلاص نهاية.
And they will accept blood money and will give them whatever they want and the problem is dealt with them.
فقال الشيطان هذا هو الرأي.
And the shaitan was excited and he said that, you know,
هذا هو الرأي.
This is the right opinion.
خلاص انتهى المجلس. قرروا هذا وخلاص.
That's their decision.
جمعوا شبة من قريش وأحاطوا ببيته صلى الله عليه وسلم.
So they gathered those youth from Quraysh and they surrounded the house of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi
wasallam.
So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave Ali his cloak and he let him sleep in his place, knowing that he will not be harmed. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم left in the middle of the night.
من بينهم.
Right in front of
them. ودر على رؤوسهم جميعا التراب. أصابهم النار.
And he sprinkled on their heads dust, and all of them fell asleep.
وخرج يقرأ قول الله تعالى ياسين والقرآن الحكيم. إنك لمن المرسلين على صراط مستقيم تنزيل العزيز الرحيم لتنذر قوما ما أنذر آباؤهم من فهم غافلون لقد حق القول على أكثرهم فهم لا يؤمنون. إنا جعلنا في عناقهم أغلالا فهي إلى الأذقان فهم مقمحون وجعلنا بين أيديهم سدا ومن خلفهم سدا فأغشيناهم فهم لا يبصرون.
And Allah سبحانه وتعالى blinded them to him
because he was
reciting the verses from Surah Yasin, which you can look up their translation up until the verse where Allah says, and we placed in front of them a barrier and behind them a barrier, and we covered them so they did not see. Sure enough, they did not see him, and when he sprinkled the dust over their heads, they fell asleep until the morning. Until it's like getting hot. And then somebody passed by and saw all these young men sleeping. And he said, what are you guys doing? They got up and brushed the dust off of their heads.
زمان محمد
وخالد
زمان.
He said, you're looking, waiting for the Prophet. He left a long time ago.
فدخلوا يبحثون عن
And they came in looking for
him.
And they see Ali radiallahu anhu about 18 years old. This is the son of Abu Talib. We have no need to hurt him. So then they said, we have to catch the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. There's no way. We have to bring him back. This migration cannot be successful. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam then and Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, they waited to let things disperse. They waited in Ghar Thawr for a few days, about not more than 9 kilometers about from right on the page you can see the video of Ghar Thawr.
غار عجيب كسفينة ومثل سفينة وفيه وفيه مدخل ممكن الإنسان يقوم ويصلي كأنه سفينة سبحان الله رحمه.
But subhanAllah, it's like you're entering a ship. That you enter a narrow space.
مكان واسع. كما السفينة فيه مدخل باب يعني عجيب سبحان الله.
It feels like you're entering a ship. There's a space, you know, for around closeted from all sides, but big enough. You can pray in there and so on.
تقوم وتسجد وتجلس وأنت تشرب سجادات كبيرة.
People, they spread these large rugs over there.
وتزودوا وأخذوا لثلاث ليال في ذلك الغار.
And they took their provisions. They spent 3 nights in that cave.
وكان عبد الله بن عبد الرحمن بن أبي بكر الصديق يأتيهم كل ليلة بقطيع من الغنم ويشربون منه لبنا. ويعطيهم خبر أهل مكة وما وصلوا إليه من البحث ويرجعوا في الليل.
And عبد الرحمن, the son of Abu Bakr al-Siddiq, he would herd his sheep near the cave and every night give them news of what happened.
ويشربون من لبنه ويعود في الليل.
They would drink from his the milk from his flock and they would return.
ويرجعوا ليلة. يرجعوا كل ليلة.
And he would return to them. He would return home every night. And then give them whatever news that he had.
والنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم مختفي في الغار. ولكن اسمعوا قول الله. وإذ يمكر بك الذين قال تعالى إلا تنصروه فقد نصره الله في الماضي إذ أخرجه الذين كفروا.
What does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say relating this incident to us, showing us how you mention any incident such as this? Right? What is the right perspective and impression that should be given? What is the verse in Surah Tawbah begin with?
إِلَّا تَنْصُرُوهُ إِذَا لَمْ تَنْصُرُوهُ لَا يَحْتَجْ إِلَى نَصْرِكُمْ.
Allah says, if you do
يَا
not
صَحَابَ وَيَا قُرَيْشْ وَيَا عَالَمْ لَا يَحْتَجْكُمْ
رَسُولُهُ. O world, O Quraysh, O everyone, if you don't help the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, no problem, Allah has already given him victory.
إذ أخرجه وقت أخرجه لنا.
When he was removed from or kicked out of Mecca.
في ذلك الوقت قد نصره الله.
What is Allah? How is Allah telling us about the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم being kicked out of Mecca? That he has the victory from Allah already guaranteed. So this is the way that we mention these stories about the Prophet.
ولذلك الله تعالى قال إذ يقول لصاحبه أبو بكر خائف على النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لا تحزن إن الله معنا أنا نعرف إنه نصر.
The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم knowing his state. That when Abu Bakr as-Siddiq is looking at the situation that he's in the midst of and seeing the disbelievers right there and so on, that Allah says once he told his companion, do not be sad.
Inna Allah ma'ana. Inna Allah ma'ana. Yet Allah قال إلا تنصروا فقد نصر الله.
Right. What is the beginning of the story? The beginning of the verse. If you do not help him, then Allah has already helped him. Doesn't matter what comes after that, whatever challenges, persecution, and whatnot, it's framed by the context of he's guaranteed victory and help.
ولذلك عندما تمر كتب السير كلها ما كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يلتفت خلفه مطلقا.
And if you look at all the books of Sirah, this is indicated.
يقول ما كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يلتفت خلفه.
The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was never in his migration. Was he worried and turning around and looking around?
ما نظر خلفه.
That's it. Just going forward.
ولذلك يقولنا أبو بكر دائما كان يلتفت والنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فقط يقرأ القرآن.
أبو بكر out of his love and concern for the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and care, just attentive looking around and fearful that anything could befall the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم not worried moving
حتى يقرأ القرآن متوجه إلى المدينة.
Reciting Quran facing Medina, that's it.
قرار نهائي نحن ذاهبون بأمر من الله تعالى هذا التوجه.
We're going with the command of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. That's the direction we're going.
ثم أجدروا عبد الله بن الأريقط وكان مشركا في ذلك الوقت دليلا.
And they hired as a guide عبد الله بن الأريقط to be
أن يأخذ منهم طريقا غير معبدا غير معبدا.
He was supposed to he was hired to show them a path that is unpaved, just a path that people don't normally take.
فلما قرر ثلاث ليال انتهت أخذ بهم عبد الله بن أريقط طريقا ليست معبدة وكفار قريش تمكثوا تلك الأيام الثلاثة يبحثون عنهم ووقفوا فوق الغار ورآهم النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أبو بكر فوقهم حتى أن أحدهم لولا غار محل قدميه كما في صحيح البخاري لرآهم فصار أبو بكر يقول له يا رسول الله لو أن أحدهم نظر إلى قدميه لأرانا ويقول له يا أبا بكر ما بالك بالنيم الله ذلك.
And the incident where they were in the cave that
حديث بخاري
and the mention حديث بخاري and Muslim that the verse
طلبوه ثلاثة أيام طلبا شديدا
that for three days they're looking for him so
ورأوا أثره يرون حتى انقطع عند غار ثور
so attentively looking everywhere aggressively that he needs to be within this area just we're going to look for everywhere everybody
انقطع عنهم العلامات عند غار ثور
and they successfully tracked him not just to the mountain where he was at but to the cave that they were at
وقفوا فوق
and they stood in front of that cave and above that cave
فصار يقول أبو بكر ينظر إليهم ويرى أقدامهم فوقه
Abu Bakr is looking up and seeing their feet. And then he's saying that if any of them looks towards their feet, they would see us. And the Prophet ﷺ said, what do you think about two people that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the third one with them?
فقال لهم الوليد بن المغارة ماذا تطلبون في هذا الغار؟ هم يبحثون لأن قطع عنهم الأثر قطع عنهم الأثر في هذا المكان
So then,
قطع عنهم أثر لأنهم كانوا ينظرون إلى أثرهم فانقطع عند غاره
الله بن
وليد بن المغيرة
So وليد بن المغيرة
لأن قطع عنهم الأثر في هذا المكان ما وجدوهم تجاوز
Now when the tracks ended there So then they're like, okay, well, could they be in the cave?
فقال لهم الوليد بن المغيرة ما بالكم تبحثون عن الكهف وعليه حمامتان وعششت عليه العنكبوت من قبل ميلاد محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم هنا حمامتان وحشيتان هذا غير معقول
So وليد بن المغيرة he said what are you talking
ماذا تطلبون هنا
what are you doing talking about this cave or not that cave look there's a wild pigeons who put their nest at the head of
والعنكبوت يعني عششت عليه من قبل ميلاد محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم
you see the spider that put its web and this is nobody's entered here since before the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was born
عجيب يعني العنكبوت وعششت خلال ثانويات والأمر القضاء وخلاص أضعف الحيوان
but سبحان الله the weakest animal this spider made its web within moments to cover the cave for the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم
وخلاص رجعوا خلاص انقطع أمله
so then that's it they gave up hope and they turned around
فقالوا لجميع الناس نحن لدينا جائزة
So then they're like, we have no choice. There's a bounty now. So then 100 camels bounty for the heads of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم or Abu Bakr al-Siddiq. Right, this is a fortune that is being offered.
فصار كل واحد يحلم بهذه الجائزة.
Everybody dreaming of this fortune.
لما انقطعت تلك الأيام الثلاثة سمع سراقة بن مدرج بخبر أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أبا بكر شيء يدل على ذلك في مكان كذا.
So one of those bounty
يتجسسون.
Was سراقة بن مدرج who heard that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم
يعني شيء يدل على ذلك هناك
that some couple people had passed by This way,
مكان كذا وكذا.
Such and such place.
فركب فرسه وتقلد سيفه خلاص.
So he successfully tracked them down, they tracked down their the news about them, and he took his sword and he rode after them in the direction he knew they were going in. And he caught up to them. So then, now once Abu Bakr, of course, was turning around, sees and looking around, he finally sees Suraqah. So then he says, "Oh, Abu Bakr of Allah," he said, "This is Suraqah ibn Mudlij." And of course, right, he knew him. He was very knowledgeable about different people in the tribes and so on. The Prophet continued forwards.
فاستمر ويقرب منه ويقول هذا سراقة بن
مدرج. He's catching up to us.
الآن عندنا ابن الجمل.
He's catching the back of our camel.
فقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم اللهم اكفنا سراقة.
All the Prophet ﷺ said, "Oh Allah, take care of سراقة for us."
فغابت فرأسه في الصخر.
The rocks.
غابت قوائم فرسه في الصخر.
The horse started to melt into the rocks.
صخر.
To sink.
غابت غابت غابت.
His feet disappeared inside of the rocks.
فخاف الهلاك.
And Suraqah became terrified.
فخرجت مرة أولى ثم في الثانية كانت أضيف.
And but then when he was saved and let go, then he started to go again after the process.
فغابت مرة ثانية.
Even deeper.
فخرج من الثانية.
And then he was let go.
فأراد اللحاق بهم فغابت قوائمه.
He still insisted on following them. Now he began
حتى شم رائحة الموت.
Until so deep he was going to, he smelled the smell of death.
فقال يا رسول يا محمد بالأمان الأمان.
He said, "Oh Muhammad, safety, safety, just save me."
اسمع هل هذا رجل خائف هل هذا رجل
مطار. What is the situation of a person who is saying, "Save me, oh Muhammad"? Help us.
فرأى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال له يا أبا بكر اكتب له كتاب لكن بشرط. ألا يدل علينا أحدا ولا يعينه ولا يذكر خبرنا لأحد وإذا سمع أننا أن هذا الدين أظهره الله تعالى يأتي وقوم مسلمين. اكتب الكتاب.
That he said. So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, "I will let you go, but under these conditions."
بشروط.
Oh, Abu Bakr, you know, write these conditions. Have him accept these conditions. That number one, he's not going to tell anybody. He's not going to help anybody find us. Against us in the future as a non-believer. And once Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives victory to this deen, that him and his people come to us as believers. هذا كان مكتوب في ذلك
الورقة كتبها أبو بكر. الوفاق. ثم قال له يا سراقة كيف بك إذا لبست سوارك كسرى.
And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم now in this situation, right?
اسمعوا.
What a person who's kicked out is saying this.
قال يا سراقة.
Oh سراقة, what do you think about a day when you're going to be wearing the bangles of كسرى?
And
the leader of the greatest, biggest empire in the world.
كسرى فاز. قال له يا كسرى فاز.
You mean كسرى, the leader of the Persians?
قال نعم.
Of course. Yes.
نعم ستلبس سواري كسرى.
Yes, you're going to wear the bangles of كسرى.
هذا شيء عجيب. هذا شيء آخر. هذا علم الغيب.
Right. This is something else. This is would drive have driven Abu Jahl crazy, right? What's the explanation here?
هذا خبر جيد. هذا سمعه مفتيك سيقول كفر.
نعم. Your مفتي would say that this is.
أبو جهل هو مفتيك سيقول أن هذا كفر.
مفتي أنا أبو جهل would have said that this was kufr and this is knowledge of the unseen and this is the
only. أنا يا سراقة كيف بك إذا لبست سوارك
كسرى. Because only, right? And Allah gave it doesn't matter. Allah.
هذا شيء مستحيل كسرى كسرى فارس. قال الكسرى فارس. طيب خلاص. أرجع إلى أهلك.
He said.
وافق على هذا وخلاص.
So he said, "Agree to this, and you go back here." Your business is not how we're going to take over Persia and what's going to happen. Just if you fulfill these conditions.
It's my job. Business.
Right. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم's business is that's not your.
كل واحد يأخذ عمله. أنت عندك وفاق وخلاص.
Right. Know your place. Know your agreement. You do your part, and that's what you have to worry about.
يقول شعر فسل أكاسرة الفرس الأولى ملك وسل مرازبة عزو بأجنادي وسل قياصرة الروم الغلاب وسل سيف ابن ذي يزن والتبع الهادي وسل هوازن إذ أبوا بفلهم مقرنين بأغلال وأصفاد وسل طوائف أحزاب وقد جمعوا عرمرما لا صدور ذات أحقاد يخبرك كلهم أن الرسول له قول من الله متبوع بأمداد وكلما حمي الأوطاس واتقدت تحت التنانير نار ذات إيقاد ألفيته جنة الأبطال أجمعهم من الزبير وعباس ومقداد لتترس كما بحديث صحيح وأمامه سل أكاسرة الفرس الأولى ملك سلهم
سبحان الله very eloquent poetry impossible to
سل أكاسرة الفرس الأولى ملك سلهم
so he said ask the leaders of Persia who led
الذين ملكوا الآلاف السنين سلهم آلاف السنين
ask basically all the enemies
سل أقياصرة سل
القياصرة ask the Caesars of Rome
سل الفراعنة
ask the pharaohs
سل العالم كله
what happened to their nations what happened to their kingdoms
يخبرك كلهم يخبرك كلهم
what happened when they faced the prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم each one of the enemies of Islam each one of the people who faced the prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and the companions
يخبرك بماذا لقى
they'll tell you what they encountered when
يخبرك انه ما يقول في الحمام بدون حراسة
That they said that they could not even go to the bathroom without being guarded after they knew the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
والله الذي لا إله إلا هو إن جميع القياصرات وفارس ما بهم واحد يحلم بالأمان ليلة واحدة من رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. والله الذي لا إله إلا الله.
That not for a day those people could feel safe from the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم when they knew he was coming.
ونصبت بالرعب الرعب مسافة مسافة شهر حديث صحيح البخاري.
The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم
شهر كامل.
صحيح البخاري. That I was given the victory through fear that the enemies would feel a month before I would come.
شهر كامل شهر كامل كسرى يرتب أمره يرتب الحراسة للحمام شهر مسكين.
قال يا أستاذي أن سبحان الله اللهم يسمون المسلمين إرهابيين فعلا الذين يعتدون على المسلمين فعلا سيشعرون بالرعب يعني المسلمين الذين هم على الحق سيكون سبب للرعب ليس ذم So he said that one of my teachers he said that don't worry he said Muslims are made fun of they're being called terrorists so that anybody who is opposing the Muslims right and the Muslims are basically on the truth not the terrorists and what the terrorists do that does not apply to them The people who are genuinely terrorists, but the Muslims who are genuinely on the truth, when their enemies oppose them, a month in advance, the terror reaches the hearts of the people
who are opposing the Muslims. سلهم.
But ask سلهم. Them. Ask the people.
يخبرك كلهم بما لقيا. يخبرك كلهم.
They'll all tell you what.
يخبرك كلهم أن الرسول له عون من الله نصر من الله.
They will tell you the messenger of Allah has a special assistance from Allah سبحانه وتعالى. That's it.
وكلما حمي الأوطاس واتقدت تحت التنانير اشتعلت الحرب رأيت النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أمام الجميع هو قائد هو الوقاية أمامه بينهم وبين الكفار.
Increasing and that
لما تبلغ الحرب غايتها.
That the furnace of
the. تشتعل نيران الحرب.
Is heated up.
من هو أمام الجيش؟
Who did you see at the front of the
army? البيت هو جنة وقاية الأبطال أجمعين.
The heroes and the champions are using the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم as their shield. They're standing behind him to cool them from this furnace of the heat of battle.
البيت هو جنة الأبطال أجمعين. علي رضي الله عنه قال كنا نتقي برسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إن القوم.
Ali رضي الله عنه said that we used to have Ali, the champion of Islam and the Muslims. He said that we used to stand behind the Prophet as a guard to protect ourselves from the enemy. هذا ليس من يعني
لا هذا خوف أما لما يبلغ الحال يعلم النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم والمرجع خلاص نهائي
Right, once the battle reached the level where they're in danger, they knew that the place that they would be safe
was
They understood, you know, where they're safe.
There's
no one to turn to, nowhere to hide behind, nor the best refuge is with the Prophet
ثم إن سراقة سمعت تلك القصة فتعجب قال سراقة بن مدرج وبعد ذلك أسلم قال سواري كسرى هذا أمر العجيب
سيقول الناس أن الكلام الذي كتب بالإنجليزي شر and قلت أفضل يعني the best refuge is the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
نعم.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a provider of refuge.
نعم.
And
the greatest.
Don't
tell him.
And the greatest means.
Stop. Don't tell him.
No need to even clarify the detail. The best refuge is the Prophet
صلى الله عليه وسلم.
So this same bounty hunter who the Prophet ﷺ guaranteed him to wear the bangles of Kisra, the life of the Prophet ﷺ in this world ended. Abu Bakr Siddiq passed away. Now many years of Umar being the Khalifa passed, still it did not happen. Now years passed and now finally Umar conquered the Persian Empire. And from the spoils of war were the bangles of
Kisra.
And they were so massive that no one could even wear them because of their size.
فجاء سراقة لأنه كان كبير الجسم رضي الله عنه أسلم ودخل الإسلام وخلاص انتهى الأمر.
He's been a Muslim for years and he's mashallah a champion and he was a bounty hunter, a very strong warrior. Now he was able to wear them.
And he wore
those bangles of Kisra just like the Prophet said he would. So Umar radiallahu anhu comes in and he sees him. He said, "What's that on your arm? Take it off." So then Suraqa said, "Would you take off of me what the Prophet gave me?" So then Umar radiallahu anhu said, "Wait, hold on. What did the Prophet say? What were the words he said?" Right, okay, yes. We believe
you're
truthful, but let's see what did the Prophet ﷺ say. He said, what is it going to be your state when you're wearing the bangles of
Kisra?
He said, as for wearing, you wore them. As for giving, he did not give them to you.
He
says, the wealth of the Muslims. Right, these were the leaders of the Muslims.
واستمر النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ينتظره الأنصار رضوان الله عليهم يشتاقون إلى ما سمع لأنه وقع قبل ذلك البيعة مع أصحاب العقبة ومع يعني جاءه وفود من الأنصار قبل ذلك على مرتين وتوافقوا معه على الهجرة وصاروا يرتقبونه.
So then the problem.
لأنه وقعت من مقابلات مع بعض الأنصار. عند بيعة العقبة وعند يعني
of course there was many incidents before that we did not mention that the Ansar of Medina they
had
come to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم given their pledge with him they were sent a teacher and they promised to defend him that they if he came to Medina like they would defend their own families.
So now
when they knew that his journey had begun, they were going to the outskirts of Medina and looking for his coming until they couldn't withstand the heat and they would return.
إلى أن كان يوم الاثنين في ربيع الأول فهاجر النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يوم الاثنين ودخل المدينة يوم الاثنين ونبئ يوم الاثنين وانتقل إلى رفيق الأعلى يوم الاثنين.
And when it was Monday, the Prophet ﷺ finally appeared, just as it was Monday when the Prophet ﷺ was born, just like it was Monday when the Prophet ﷺ left for the Hijrah, he arrived on the Hijrah on Monday. And just like that, the Prophet ﷺ left this world as well on a Monday. And he was sent as a messenger on the day of Monday, honoring the day of Monday over the other days.
فلما كان يوم الاثنين بعد ارتقاب كثير فعله الأنصار دخل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم المدينة.
And then
في ربيع الأول.
It was Monday in ربيع الأول as well. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم made المدينة المدينة.
فدخلها ووجد
by his entry.
انفض إليه الأنصار الترحيب والتعظيم وصار كل طائفة لأننا سنفتصل صارت كل طائفة منهم تريدون أن ينزل عندهم.
That now when he was welcomed by the Ansar, every group wanted, and we're going to cut things short, of course, that summarizing, that every group wanted him to live with them in every tribe.
كل قوم يريدون ضيافته استضافته.
Everybody wanted to host him.
فيقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم دعوها فإنها مأمورة يعني.
He tried to take the reins of his camel, but he would say, leave it for it is commanded. It's going to stop where it is commanded. And then finally, it rested in the place that is now in the masjid of the Prophet
ﷺ.
And that's where the masjid was placed. And the man who ended up having the honor of hosting the Prophet ﷺ was Abu Ayyub al-Ansari, who is in fact buried in Istanbul today. That he took his stuff, he took the Prophet ﷺ to his house. And the companions were deliberating. Prophet ﷺ said, where is my stuff? He said, Abu Ayyub al-Ansari already took it. He said, the Prophet ﷺ said, well, a man is with his equipment, his gear. So while the masjid was being built and the rooms of the Prophet ﷺ were built, he spent those days with Abu Ayyub
al-Ansari.
And it was an adobe house, a clay house, that was a mud house that was two levels.
فقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم خلوا لنا الأسفل من البيت لأننا ننتظر الضيوف والداخلين والزائرين وهذا أليق بنا وتكون أنت والزوجة الفوق يعني العائلة تكون الفوق.
It was a two-story house, so the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, out of mercy to them, said, look.
رحمة بالناس كلها لأنه يستقبل الناس.
Everybody who's coming to visit him, he said, okay, look, I will take the bottom floor and then.
ما أرادوا أن يكون الفوق طبعاً.
And they told him take the top. He said, no, but people will be coming all
the time.
It's easier for the people to come in, and also you won't be disturbed with everybody coming in and passing by you to go upstairs. No, just come, well, I'll take the bottom floor. Make it easier for people. People passing by you all the time and people climbing, everybody having to climb. No, you go up and I'll be at the bottom.
مكث هناك بعضا من الوقت وكان البيت من الطين يسير منه الماء. ففي وقت من الوقات صنع شيء وسال ماء على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من الفوق.
So then this was a mud house. So then what happened? The Abu Ayyub al-Ansari, he was on the top level, and then they were making something, or perhaps some water had spilled, and of course, it being a mud house, it leaked to the bottom level. Abu Ayyub al-Ansari just could not handle that. So then what they did, they just were just so terrified of disturbing the Prophet ﷺ, spilling something, bothering him in the slightest, that they spent the whole night plastered to the corner of the top floor. And then the next day they said, with all due respect to the Prophet ﷺ, that this is not something we can do, we cannot be above you at all. This
خلاص وسنتين هنا وأقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم سبحان ربك رب العزة. هذه حياة المسلمين. وفهمها ضروري.
And understanding this is required.
يرجع عليها الاعتقاد ويرجع عليها الإيمان ويرجع عليها اليقين ويرجع عليها كل شيء. يرجع
عليها كل شيء. يرجع
عليها كل شيء. من أمور الدنيا والآخرة وبدونها عزة المسلمين لا توجد.
And without it, the honor of the Muslims is lost.
And
that is why today you do not have honor.
لا تعلمون من أنتم.
You do not even know who you are.
لا تعلمون من نبيكم.
You do not know.
مكة كم في مكة.
How long did he spend in Mecca?
لا تعلمون.
You do not know him.
13 سنة.
13 years.
مكة كم في المدينة.
In Mecca. How long in Medina?
10 سنين.
10 years.
هاجر من ما إلى ما لا.
He migrated from what city to what city?
حتى تقول إنه هاجر من أوروبا إلى أمريكا. الله تعالى.
Did he migrate from Europe to America?
لأن هذا هو ذوقكم ومحبتكم.
That's the migration that you seem to love.
أين قبره صلى الله عليه وسلم؟
Where is his grave?
زيارة شرك.
You say that visiting him is shirk.
أنتم مصابون.
أمام قبر النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
كلهم.
كيف تمسوا أشياء لا تنفعكم ولا تضركم؟
وكيف تأكل أشياء لا تنفعكم ولا تضركم؟
قال لا لا لا.
وكيف تتزوجون أشياء لا تنفعكم ولا تضركم؟
لم توجد رحمة من عفوك. Two things I've personally heard with my ears at the grave of the Prophet ﷺ. You guys are touching things that are not going to benefit you or harm you. Okay. There is no mercy descending here.
Okay.
My own ears. I was told the second one myself to me. The first time I
looked
there. I heard the person that cleans the grave of the Prophet ﷺ, what he said was just light upon light upon light.
سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك اشهد ان لا اله الا انت استغفرك واتوب اليك